Welcome to this how-to video. Today in this video I'm going to show you how you can set up the so-called LineScan function. The software PIX Connect has such this LineScan function, which is mainly used for continuously processes where the measurement objects are moving. For example, this could be a thermal forming process, or a float glass process, or also a sheet glass application. To better explain the setup for the LineScan function to you, let's have a look on this small demonstration model. On the model, we transport a glass sheet from the heating zone via transportation rollers under a small slit into the cooling zone. The small slit can have a dimension down to 5 mm. To allow the LineScan function to be set up, the complete form width of the measurement objects needs to be within the field of view of the camera under the gap. For this, the glass sheet has to be stopped directly under the gap. Now, let's have a look how to set up the LineScan function in the PIX Connect software step by step. To activate the LineScan function, go to the menu Tools, LineScanner Mode, and click on Enable LineScanner. You are now in the alignment view and you can apply all the adjustments in the view. To do the settings, go to the menu item LineScanner Mode, LineScanner Settings. In the LineScan Configuration menu, select the tab General. Here you can set the mode for the LineScan. You can choose a continuously triggered or self-triggered or external triggered LineScan. In our example, we want to use a self-triggered LineScan. So activate the item self-triggered. Next, a temperature trigger threshold needs to be set, which triggers the LineScan process. In our example, the LineScan is to be triggered when a temperature of 50 degrees is reached. Click on Apply to save the settings. Now select the tab Source. For our LineScan, we are going to use a self-defined line. To do so, activate the item Scan on User Defined Line. Click on Apply and OK. In the alignment view, you can now see the self-trigger area in the top left position and a diagonal position scan line. Now you have the possibility to position the self-trigger area in the image as required. For this, grab one corner of the self-trigger area field and hold the control key on your keyboard. Now you can move the complete self-trigger area field. The self-trigger area must always be located before the scan line in the direction of movement of the object. It should be sufficiently large to detect the moving object. In our case, the object moves from the top to the bottom direction. Next, we position the scan line below the trigger area. For this, grab one edge of the scan line and hold the control key to move the complete scan line. The scan line must cover at least the full length of the object. To change the direction and length of the scan line, grab one edge of the scan line and move it to the right position and length. The object will later scan line by line at this position and compiled into an image. Next, we open the LineScan Configuration menu again. So click on Tools, LineScanner Mode, and LineScanner Settings. Now select the tab Presentation. The presentation of the resulting LineScan should be from top to bottom. So activate the item Top Down. Now you can decide if you want to use the length width presentation mode or the line count presentation mode. Let's start with the line count presentation mode. At this mode, the display of the line scan is done by the scan time and the line count. Here you can decide how many lines have to be scanned and in which time. The resulting line rate here should correspond to the maximum image frequency of the used camera. In our example, the glass sheet takes 10 seconds to pass across the gap. We want to use the full frame rate of 32 Hz. Therefore, 320 lines must be set in the field line count. You have also the possibility to enter the length of line. Now select the tab Auto Snapshots and activate the first item. Here you can decide after how many scanning runs a snapshot should be taken in each case. Click on Apply and OK. To start the line scanner process, go to the menu item Tools, Line Scanner Mode, and click on Line Scanner Sighting View. Let's check our line scanner settings. Now, when the glass sheet is transported on the conveyor belt, the glass sheet is scanned under the gap line by line, and we get as output a complete image on the screen. Finally, we will get also a snapshot. To have all snapshots of the individual line scan processes displayed, go to the menu item View, Windows, Snapshot History. Now you can see all the recorded snapshots in an additional window. You can put the window to a position on the screen wherever you like. To set a measurement field on the object, go to the menu item Tools, Configuration, and select the tab Measure Areas. By clicking on the Add button, you can add a new measuring area. Enter a name for the measuring area and select the relevant shape. In our example, we are going to select a polygon. This polygon has four coordinates for the four corners of the used glass sheet. Click on Apply and OK. Now you can move the polygon to the right positions on the screen by keeping the Control button on your keyboard and dragging the polygon to the correct location using the mouse. Drag each corner to change the shape of the polygon. As you can see, we are now measuring the temperature of the complete surface of the glass sheet. Alternative, you can also use the length with presentation mode set up in the PIX Connect software. For this, go to the menu Tools, Line Scanner Mode, Line Scanner Settings. Go to the tab Presentation and activate the item Length Width. Here you can enter the dimensions, length and width of your heating zone. Additionally, you also have to enter the feed rate. This is the speed, how fast the object is coming out of the heating zone. Now you know how you can use the LineScan function with the PIX Connect software.